How do you know somebody's attracted to you or not? And then what do you do about it?
I guess you know if they want to talk to you a lot.
Okay. Okay. All right. So that's probably a good sign. Anything else? What about the strong silent type?
I don't know. I've never met one of those. I like loud people.
Okay. Oh, it's probably that you haven't met them because you haven't noticed that they was liking you, huh?
Maybe so.
How do you know when somebody is attracted to you or not? And then what do you do about it?
Wow. Simple but tricky question. How do you know?
Yeah.
Well, you got the straightforward. They're going to let you know, bump into you like 5 times within the minute.
Okay.
Then you got the less subtle version, which is very delicate. Mm. But I guess there's that, what they call it, the pheromones? There's a thing.
Oh, the pheromones?
Yeah, there's a thing in the air. You can feel it tapping you on your shoulder. Hey, I'm calling you in the back over here behind the girl in the pink dress. So it kind of works sometimes. You gotta feel it.
How do you know when somebody's interested in you or not? And what do you do about it?
Ah, that's a good question. I mean, I think it's a very unspoken thing, and it's more about the energy that you feel with somebody. And I think that if you have that open connection, then you should be open with them about it verbally as well as with your energy, and bring good energy as well.
Well, I can only tell girls, and you know, they would look at you with a certain spark in their eyes, and there is something that they tell you right away. And I think you just got to be able to see it.
Okay, good. So if you like them, then what happens?
Then I guess you keep hanging around and see if it goes well.
Okay. How do you tell the energy? Is it like is there any signal? Because, you know, there's people just trying to figure this out. You know,
one of the most relevant things for me is eye contact. You know, if you look somebody in the eye, then I think that helps a lot. And if they look back at you in the eyes, you're sharing some sort of connection. And if it's a good connection, you'll know it because they're looking back at your eyes, which is cool.
Okay, good. Anything else?
I'd like to spit a rhyme about love if you got a second.
Roll with it.
Okay. This one's called Ride It Out, and it's all about the importance of love and what it is to me, how love can be expressed through music and such. So here we go. This love may be the finest, she is my royal highness. I never thought I'd find this high divineness. She comes around and says, come and get inside this. So I close my eyes and see the light in the blindness. I wanna cleanse and rinse this, just for an instant, celebrate existence. I trace her footprints in this beat, there's a rhyme for every reason. Call it hip hop or a brand new way of feeling. Coming out the silence, she offers guidance, taming Babylon and New York City sirens. She turns it up, light spot where this mic is. This oracle of love is so bright. So shake the world, every rhythm and word. Feel the pulse on the street and the rhythm of the earth. And let's align sacredly like twisting strands in this love genealogy. Cause we're on a love journey and one love is what we gotta get.
Word. Y'all gotta get up with my man Ty over here.
Now you gotta step your game up now. Now you gotta get the walk on with the talk. You know, which New Yorkers are most comfortable with? We got that rep, that smoothest rep.
Yeah.
You know, no, not too soft, not too hard.
Yeah.
You know, you got to step your game up. You approach her, you let her know that, you know, you like what you see.
Got to come strong. That's what I'm hearing, right?
That's right. You know, you got to have your shoe game up, your pocketbook game up. Even know a little bit of the scents. Like, oh, I love the rose scent on you tonight. So, you know, okay. Fellas, listen up. Ladies, listen up.
So I'm hearing some compliments, right?
Oh, definitely.
Okay.
Definitely.
All right.
There's nothing that they're not going to come up with a present or anything. They're not going to give you a present.
What?
Say, hey, take me home. They're just going to tell you with their little eyes. And then, you know, they kind of put it out there for you. And then you know what to do after.
I'm appalled. I haven't had anybody do that to me either, you know?
Are you sure?
100%.
It happens to me all the time, though. I'm not bragging.
Oh, listen, I need your address, man. I need to follow around you. Maybe as a coach, I'll pay you
maybe
to coach me.
Maybe I should be the coach. Yeah.
I want to have that, you know? So now that you got a sense of it, is there anything else you want to say about, like, any other hints besides the way they look at you?
Man, I think that's the only hint you want to have. Because that's part of the game. Then you know, then it's up to you. And they're going to respond to it accordingly, you know. You can mess it up or you can make it good.
Ah, I like that. I like that. There's a lot of confidence coming out of here with this ukulele. I want y'all to know.
Oh, man, I think that what you have to do is just be yourself and be kind. and treat your women right, you know? You have to treat your girls with respect. That's the key thing, you know? And then you gotta have confidence, you know? Because women don't like guys who don't have confidence. And then you gotta go with the flow.
I'm feeling you, man. You know,
isn't that true though?
Yeah, it is true. I'm watching you, man. I'm like, this guy's playing a ukulele. He's got music down. He's got the bedroom eyes. You know, he's fit, little salt and pepper, looking all mature. Dude, I'm surprised that I didn't have to like knock a bunch of women out of the way to come talk to you, man. You know. So now, what happens if you don't like them?
Then you politely do not accept their calls.
Okay.
Ah, that's a tricky one. What I would say is use your friendliness and at the same time be a little bit reserved and detached from her feelings and at the same time be open about the way you feel in as nice as way possible if you're a nice person. And there's other ways to show love towards somebody even when, you know, you don't love them the same way that you think they love you as well, so.
Yeah, well, you know, since you're an entertainer, you know, you got to sound like a little political answer. I like it,
bit,
you know.
Yeah. Got to throw it in there.
Oh, separation. Get out of there. Break out.
What do you mean? You like make an exit or, you know, you excuse yourself or?
I mean, what you could do, a smart man would kind of like check the group out, you know, check the rest of the group out. You can use that friend as ally towards the ultimate goal. They could be a member of the crew.
Oh, you got a lot of game. You know, you've been in the trenches a little bit, huh?
Born in Brooklyn, baby. Born in Brooklyn.
Oh, stuff.
I think when people like you, they're giving you a lot of themselves. And that's that has a lot of value. So, you know, if you're not attracted to them, there's nothing you can do, you know? But, so I think what I try to do is I try to steer the situation to where it's clear that a friendship, it's the one thing that should happen, you know?
Very sensitive. I really got that, you know?
I play the ukulele. I'm a sensitive man.
True, true, true.
This is the most romantic song I ever heard.
Thank you, my brother, from down under. Thank you.
Thank you.